I got that calif.
Again, welcome back. And for today, I thought I'd show you guys my essentials for spring break, because I know that spring break is almost here. I can literally taste the beach already. But yeah, today I'm gonna show you guys my essentials when I do go to the beach, and I'm also gonna be showing you guys some DIY smoothies so you guys can be refreshed throughout your whole week of spring break. Okay, so here's the funny story, guys. So my official plan for this video was to go to the beach, but here in California, the weather is so bipolar. It rained for like 3 days, and it was with thunder and lasers. Okay, anyways, so it was with thunder. So that kind of like messed up my plans, but that did not stop me from doing this video. And yeah, I think I've done a bunch of talking. So without any further ado, let's just get started with this video, shall we? Okay guys, so I'm starting off with my essentials, and my first essential is obviously some sunscreen, because we're gonna be in the sun all day, so it's very important for us to take care of our skin. My second essentials are some sunglasses, because nothing ruins a perfect beach day than just squinting your eyes like at the sun all day. And just make sure that when you do take your sunglasses, take your cheap ones. And okay guys, so this essential might be a little bit weird to you guys, but surprisingly, we also have to take care of our hair. You have to buy a hairspray that can protect your hair from the sun rays, because it gets it like really, really dry. And for a girl's worst nightmare, you get more chances of getting split ends. My fourth essential are some snacks, because every time I go to the beach, I always get hungry, like super hungry. So always take some snacks with you, and also comment down below which ones are your favorite snacks to take to the beach, because mine are some hot Cheetos and M&Ms. Another essential of mine are some flip-flops, and with the sandals too, just make sure that you take your cheap ones, just because sometimes I forget about my sandals, and then once I remember, like, I see them all the way deep inside into the ocean. So just make sure that you take your cheap ones. So I'm pretty sure that your phone is gonna die, so take your portable charger, and you won't have to go through that struggle of saving the battery. You know, just take your portable charger and make your life a lot easier. And lastly but not least, make sure that you take your playlist with you, because it's always nice to listen to your own music when you're at the beach and you can party it up with your friends. And also comment down below which one's your favorite band, because I cannot stop listening to Odessa. Currently, that's my obsession. Okay, so now we're moving on to making some refreshing smoothies. And the first smoothie that I'm gonna show you guys is how to make this Lipton smoothie. So what you're gonna need is some Lipton tea, and you guys can choose your favorite flavor. You're also gonna need some raspberries, blueberries, blackberries, mint, and an ice cube tray. Now to start off, the first thing that you're gonna do is to put all of your food into the ice tray, and just make sure that you put them all over the place. Don't be scared to put a lot of fruit, because I feel like the more fruit that you put, the better. And also don't forget to put your little mint leaves, because that gives it like a little extra spice, and it's a lot more refreshing too. And then once you are done putting all of your fruit, then you are just gonna take your Lipton tea and you are just gonna pour it into the ice cube tray. Once you're done with that, then you are just going to put it in the freezer for about 2 hours. And once the 2 hours have passed, you should have like super hard ice cubes of Lipton tea and fresh fruit. And then you are just gonna put those into a blender and you are just gonna blend it. But before you blend it, make sure that you put a little bit of tea so that way it won't get stuck. Oh, it's not the same thing. Need to feel the pressure somewhere on my body. On my body. Once it's done blending, then you are just gonna put it into a nice mason jar and then you are just going to decorate it. I put like 2 blackberries and I also put a fresh mint and a colorful straw because we are on spring break. And yeah, that's pretty much it, you guys. Now for my second smoothie, it's a little bit on the spicy side. So what you're gonna need is mango pulp. You're also gonna need 1 cup of sugar, 1 pinch of salt, 1/3 cup of squeezed lemon juice, 1 cup of ice, 1 cup of water, little pieces of fresh mangoes, 1/3 cup of chamoy, which is a hot sauce. And lastly but not least, you are gonna need a spicy powder. Pretty much you're gonna put all of these ingredients into a blender. And for the mango pulp, I put like 1/2 of the bag. And like I said before, you guys, this drink is really spicy, but if you wanna tone it down a little, then you can always add a little bit more sugar. And that will make it a lot sweeter. So once we're done blending all of those ingredients, then we are just going to take a mason jar. And as you can see here, I already added little pieces of fresh mangoes and I also added more sauce. But then you are just going to pour it into the mason jar. And then once that is done, then you are just going to put more fresh mango on top and we are going to top it off with some chili powder. And that's pretty much it, you guys. Hope you enjoy. You guys, hopefully you guys liked this video, and if you guys did, don't forget to like and also don't forget to subscribe down below because I want you to subscribe to my channel. Why would you not subscribe to my videos? And also comment down below what's your favorite thing to do on spring break, because with me, I know that I like to sleep in a lot. So yeah, thank you guys so much, and with that being said, I will see you guys next time. Bye. Something about